Electricity is generated in the power plants and is transmitted through power lines. To reduce the losses, electricity is transmitted at very high voltages. We have a high voltage AC transmission system and a high voltage DC transmission system. In today's video, we are going to see 10 comparisons between these two. Hi, I'm Benila and you're watching The Learning Curve. Countries that generate surplus electricity trade and share electricity with neighboring countries. The main thing to consider here is that two countries that share electricity should have the same electrical frequencies. But what if their frequencies don't match? We cannot use high voltage AC transmission to interconnect the power grids with different frequencies. However, HVDC is very useful in interconnecting the power grids with different frequencies. Because DC frequency is zero, so we don't have to worry about the frequency matching. As I said earlier, electricity is transmitted at very high voltages to reduce the losses. Therefore, the generated electricity is first transmitted to the step-up transformer, which converts low voltage electricity into high voltage electricity. So, the typical high voltage AC transmission consists of a step-up transformer, transmission lines, and at the receiving end, we have a step-down transformer for distributing the transmitted electricity. High voltage DC transmission is very similar to high voltage AC transmission, except that it requires a converter at each end of the transmission line. The sending end converter receives the input from the step-up transformer and converts this high voltage AC electricity into high voltage DC electricity. This converter is called the rectifier. The receiving end converter receives the high voltage DC input and converts it back to high voltage AC or HVAC. This converter is called the inverter. Compare the structure of HVAC and HVDC. Obviously, the presence of converters will increase the installation cost of the HVDC transmission system. These semiconductor converters are very expensive. When a conductor is carrying alternating current, this current is not uniformly distributed over the whole cross-section of the conductor. This is called the skin effect. The current tends to concentrate only near the surface of the conductor. This means the electric current flows mainly at the skin of the conductor between the outer surface and the level called the skin depth. Skin depth depends on the frequency. As the frequency increases, the current flow moves to the surface, resulting in less skin depth. Similarly, as frequency decreases, the skin depth increases. When frequency is zero, there is no skin effect in the conductor. This means the current is uniformly distributed over the whole cross-section of the conductor. Zero frequency refers to DC. Now compare these two. For the same amount of current to transmit, AC transmission requires a conductor with a larger diameter. This means HVDC transmission requires thinner conductors than HVAC transmission. Corona loss will be less in HVDC transmission than in HVAC transmission. Interference with nearby communication lines is less in case of an HVDC overhead line than that of an HVAC line. The absence of reactive power in HVDC transmission reduces the power loss in HVDC. In HVAC, we have single circuit transmission lines and double circuit transmission lines. A single circuit transmission line has three sets of conductors. A double circuit transmission line has two independent circuits. This means it has 6 conductors. The 3 types of HVDC links are monopolar link, bipolar link and homopolar link. The monopolar link has only 1 conductor. Bipolar and homopolar links have 2 conductors. HVAC transmission is economical only for short distance transmission, while HVDC is economical for long distance transmission. In submarine power cables, typically for a route of less than 80 km, high voltage AC submarine power cables would be the most economical system. However, beyond this length, high voltage DC submarine power cables are used. That's all for today. Bye. See you in my next video.